Alright, in this video I want to talk about finding limits graphically. And so here we've got our function f of x. We've got a little removable discontinuity at negative 4. We have a jump discontinuity here at 5. So part A, we just want to ask ourselves, does the limit as x approaches negative 4 exist for this function? Well, again, as x approaches negative 4, I'm thinking about what's happening to the y values. Do they approach some specific single y value? So notice if we take x values a little bit smaller than negative 4, I think about on the graph, what are the y values getting closer to? Well, the y values are getting closer and closer to the value positive 2. Likewise, as I come from the right, okay, take numbers a little bit bigger than negative 4, if I think about what's happening to the y values on the graph, again, those are getting closer and closer to 2. So I would say yes, and we can write the limit as x approaches negative 4 of our function. We would say that that equals positive 2. Again, the y values are getting closer and closer to 2. So again, notice the y value at negative 4 is something totally different. But again, it doesn't matter what actually happens at that point. We just think as you get close to negative 4 on the left and on the right, are the y values there getting close to some specific number? Yes, and in this case, that number is 2. Same question, does the limit as x approaches 5 exist for f of x? Well, if I come in from the left, okay, so here the y values are getting closer and closer to some, you know, whatever it is. Let's pretend it's up here at positive 4 just to give it a specific value. So here as we approach from the left, the y values are getting closer and closer to 4. But then when we come from the right, well, if I look at x values a little bit bigger than 5, well, now the y values are getting closer and closer to something different. Let's maybe pretend that that's, I don't know, positive 1. Well, since when you come from the left, the y values on one side get close to 4, and as when you come from the right, the y values get closer and closer to something different, in this case, positive 1. If the limit as you approach from the left and from the right is not the same, we say no, that limit does not exist. And kind of another way I always thought, for a limit to exist, for example, at negative 4, notice if I kind of put my fingers on the graph and bring them in closer and closer and closer to negative 4, they're going to basically touch. Okay, they're going to get closer and closer and closer, and that y value where they would sort of be touching would be the y value of 2, and the limit exists. If I do the same thing at x equals 5, if I put my finger, you know, on the graph and try to, you know, move them close, you know, take x values closer and closer to 5, I think, well, are my fingers going to be touching? Are they getting closer and closer together? No, because one's up here, one's down here. If that happens, we say the limit simply does not exist.